The new era of the Raptor 3 engine has begun, featuring significant system upgrades. The most notable improvement is a newly designed engine that offers increased power, efficiency, and reliability. However, there are still hurdles to overcome before it can reach its full potential. What sets this engine apart? And what challenges does SpaceX need to overcome? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. A few years ago, when SpaceX launched Raptor 2, they displayed Raptor 1 alongside it, showcasing substantial advances in design and engineering. This visual comparison clearly demonstrated the rapid evolution of SpaceX's propulsion technology. This year, that practice has been elevated to a new standard. In late August, a photo from Star Factory revealed three prototypes from different Raptor generations positioned side by side. The trio included Raptor 1, Raptor 2, and the newest edition, Raptor 3, which is highlighted by its striking black design. The prototypes are numbered 59, 352, and 20. It's clear that this arrangement was intentional, likely in preparation for the latest technical update presented by Musk. The visual comparison conveys a compelling narrative of progress. However, what really catches the eye are the new features introduced with the Raptor 3. Let's take a closer look at Prototype 20. This engine is particularly noteworthy because it features a map of Texas, representing the location of SpaceX's Starship initiative. However, the main focus is on the engine's upper systems, which have undergone significant modifications since the initial Raptor 3 prototype was introduced last year. One key improvement is the addition of a protective cover over the pipe system in the center of the engine. While this may seem like a small change, it plays a crucial role in protecting the system from the vibrations and extreme heat generated during operation. By providing this cover, fragile components are protected, and the overall organization and reliability of the engine are improved. Another improvement can be seen in the adjacent area. On the previous SN1 prototype, this area was open and had numerous visible screw points connected to the turbine that pumps methane into the combustion chamber. With the SN20, this area is now enclosed, creating a more cohesive unit. Given the fragile and sensitive nature of the turbine, this protective design significantly improves its strength and reliability during high-pressure operation. A third change is the ring at the end of the hot gas line, which is now larger and more robust than the previous version.
SpaceX appears to have shifted from using flanges to welding in its manufacturing process. This welding technique reduces weight, reduces the risk of leaks, and generally creates stronger and more durable joints. This transition not only simplifies the design, but also improves safety and efficiency. All of these changes highlight the significant progress SpaceX has made in a short time. After evaluating various prototypes, the company has moved toward a more refined and better protected version of the Raptor 3. Specifically, the SN20 prototype demonstrates SpaceX's commitment to high reliability while systematically addressing deficiencies identified in previous iterations. It's important to understand that the Raptor 3 is still in development. What we see today is not the final product, but rather the result of continuous refinement and insights. These methods are the foundation of SpaceX's strong reputation: rigorous testing, rapid learning, and continuous improvement. So, what allows SpaceX to quickly identify problems and implement fixes? The solution lies not only in visual inspection, but also in extensive testing. Since the Raptor 3's unveiling last year, reports indicate that engine testing at McGregor has been rigorous. The past few weeks have featured up to 24 tests for both Raptor 2 and Raptor 3. Many of these evaluations intentionally push the engines to their limits, sometimes leading to explosions. These extreme situations were not failures, but rather deliberate testing to uncover vulnerabilities. Through this intensive process, SpaceX has been able to identify problems and quickly implement solutions, resulting in the upgrades we see on SN20 today. Although Raptor 3 is still in development, the progress is clear. Every modification, whether it's a protective cover or a redesigned weld, marks a step toward a more reliable and powerful engine. With this rapid development, SpaceX continues to demonstrate why its engines are at the forefront of contemporary rocketry. What are your thoughts on these latest Raptor 3 advancements? Please share your thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible journey. Indeed, Raptor 3 presents one of SpaceX's most significant engineering challenges. The startup sequence is at the heart of its complexity, and Musk has described it as incredibly delicate, requiring extraordinary timing to prevent engine failure. This is no exaggeration. The engine operates on a fully staged combustion cycle, allowing methane and oxygen to flow through a pre-combustor before final combustion. This design maximizes efficiency but requires perfect precision. All components, including the igniter, cooling process, and the rapidly spinning turbine, must operate in perfect synchronization.
Even small misalignments can cause dangerous vibrations. Timings measured in milliseconds must be consistently repeated by the engines across multiple flights to ensure effective reuse. SpaceX also focused on simplifying things. By reducing components, replacing bolts and flanges with welded joints, and combining smaller components into larger groups, the Raptor 3 became lighter, more affordable, and less likely to fail. This simplification process not only reduced repair time, but also supported faster turnaround times. A comparison of Raptors 1, 2, and 3 shows significant progress, as having fewer fragile components leads to faster and safer manufacturing. However, implementing this strategy brings new challenges. Larger, integrated parts can experience greater mechanical stress, and while welded joints offer greater strength, they complicate maintenance efforts. If one breaks, engineers can't simply remove it with a bolt. They may need to cut it. These challenges highlight the delicate balance SpaceX must strike: power, reliability, reusability, and simplicity, while ensuring safety. With each upgrade, the Raptor 3 moves closer to its full potential, becoming a machine capable of propelling humans to the moon, Mars, and beyond. This latest upgrade raises the critical question of whether the Raptor 3 is truly ready for its long-awaited launch. Photos of SN20 released in August suggested that SpaceX may already have a sufficient number of engines ready for flight. A full mission requires 33 engines for the Super Heavy booster and 6 for the Starship upper stage, and given current progress, it seems plausible that more than 20 Raptor 3 engines have already been built. For now, there's no reason to be overly concerned about the exact number of engines available. The Raptor 3's sleek design and significant improvements in SpaceX's manufacturing processes suggest that production will soon accelerate, perhaps surpassing the Raptor 2's impressive output of nearly one engine per day. However, SpaceX needs to anticipate a future where Starship flight volumes increase dramatically, as the current production rate may ultimately be insufficient. There is now ample opportunity to prepare enough engines for the Raptor 3 maiden mission. If Flight 11 proceeds as planned for October, then Flight 12, the Raptor 3 maiden flight, could be ready in December. The transition is already underway. B-18 is nearing completion of stacking, with the common dome, nose section, and hot staging ring having been moved to Mega Bay 1. This suggests B-18 could undergo cryogenic testing by mid-month, after which the engines will be added. Meanwhile, S-39 is on the same track, though slightly behind in stacking, with its engines potentially installed in late October or early November. We are on the verge of the Raptor 3 era, featuring increased power, improved reliability, and a smarter design. This innovative engine holds the promise of propelling the Starship program into an exciting new phase of development.
The countdown has officially begun, marking the beginning of refinements to the Raptor 3, aims not only to improve immediate performance, but also at building a strong foundation for the future of the Starship program. Raptor 3 is unlikely to be the final iteration in the Raptor lineup. Elon Musk has frequently hinted at the potential for a future version capable of achieving thrust exceeding 330 tons at sea level, possibly dubbed Raptor 3X or Raptor 4. Musk has asserted that such a version would be crucial for Starship to achieve an overall launch thrust exceeding 10,000 tons, a point he reiterated in his latest update. The upcoming Starship V4 is projected to generate 10,000 tons of thrust from Super Heavy and 2,700 tons from the ship itself. Given that the Raptor 3 currently generates around 280 tons of thrust per engine, those figures fall far short of meeting this ambitious target, suggesting that more powerful engines are likely in development. Future models will aim not only to increase thrust, but also prioritize design simplicity, reliability, and rapid reusability, key elements of SpaceX's strategy. By improving integration, minimizing component count, and optimizing manufacturing processes, the company aims to increase power while ensuring efficiency. Reaching 10,000 tons of thrust would be a groundbreaking achievement, setting a new benchmark for rocket capabilities. As Musk has indicated, this level of thrust would be more than 3 times that of the famed Saturn V rocket, making it extremely challenging for other space initiatives to match Starship's ever-expanding potential. According to the current timeline, Starship V4 is projected to launch in 2027, suggesting that new engine variants, whether dubbed Raptor 3X or 4, could begin testing as early as next year. The performance of Raptor 3 will be crucial to this progress, as its successes and challenges will influence future developments. If all goes according to plan, next year could see several Raptor 3-powered Starship flights, providing SpaceX with valuable insights into real-world performance. This flight will play a crucial role in charting the course for the next generation of engines, ensuring that when Raptor 3X or 4 is ready, it can propel Starship into a new era marked by incredible power and reusability. Nonetheless, SpaceX continues to improve Starship throughout its engine family, with the Raptor engines exemplifying this continuous evolution. The launch of Raptor 3 will mark a pivotal moment, beginning a new phase in SpaceX's quest to create a fully reusable, robust, and reliable spacecraft. We eagerly await how Raptor 3 will redefine Starship operations and bring humanity closer to a truly multiplanetary future. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one.